Today, we will take a quick look at the Enjoywood M4 Galvo Laser Engraver. This machine is identical to the Atomstack M4, and I am sure that they share the same internals. It is very fast and very precise. It can engrave all types of metal and plastic materials. It can also be used for surface cleaning and rust removal. Check this video to see what it can really do, and I will also show you some tricks for using the included software. The machine is very compact, and it has a working area of 7 cm square. The buttons and connectors look very high quality. It has a manual focusing crank handle and a removable bottom lid, which is great for engraving on big objects. You also get the positioning bracket and a plastic cone for handheld operation. Compared to one of the smallest 20-watt fiber lasers, the COM marker before, the Enjoywood M4 looks very small. This is why I believe it is not a true fiber laser, but it has a different type of laser source. I believe that it should be more similar to the X-Tool infrared module which I have previously reviewed, paired to the fast Galvo mirror system for beam deflection. Focusing the machine is easy. By rotating the handle, you need to align the two red laser dots. Then the dots are aligned, the machine is in perfect focus. This laser is using the SeaCAD software, which is a bit stripped-down version of the EasyCAD. It feels a bit Chinese, with some non-translated warnings popping up every now and then. It takes a bit of getting used to, but it is enough for getting everything you need out of the Enjoywood M4. I have heard rumors that Lightburn is planning to support these machines too, which are a very welcoming news. You can preview the engravings with a square outline, or it can outline the vectors directly. It engraves with a very fast speed. The lines appear to be thinner than with the COM marker before, but this laser also has approximately 10 times less power. Let's see how small it can really engrave. As I am editing this, I have noticed that if looking at the real dimensions, the text is smaller than it was expected to be, due to the weird font I have chosen. This machine can engrave very small details very fast while maintaining high precision. Included with the machine, you get this awesome black paper for testing. Importing vector designs is a bit tricky. The only format that works is the DXF format. I made this vector design of a newspaper article with Kittle and then converted to DXF using Inkscape or Lightburn. It was engraved without issues. But then I tried engraving another design which didn't complete no matter what. I don't know if the issue is in the SeaCAD or in the exported file from Inkscape. I tried another design and the same happened. I think there is an issue with complex vector designs either at exporting from other software or importing into the SeaCAD. But normal designs always worked without issues. Next, I wanted to test the maximum speed of this machine since it claims it can engrave with speeds up to 12,000 mm per second. But I quickly noticed that as the speeds get very high, the pulse frequency comes into the effect since the engraved lines are not continuous anymore. True fiber lasers have a frequency setting where you can adjust the frequency of the pulses. But since this is not a true fiber laser, the change of the frequency parameter has no effect. The frequency stays the same. This laser works very well on all types of metals. Here I tried engraving in aluminum focusing blocks that I use for my other laser engravers. The engravings are quite deep and will not come off easily. It can also be used for cleaning dirty coins and for rust removal. I have set up two passes, one slower pass and another fast cleanup pass. It makes the coins look like new in seconds. I used the same settings for rust removal, I have just set a few more passes. It vaporizes the rust and leaves a clean surface. Because it has much less power, it is slower than COM marker before, but it gets the job done. When you import DXF files and set the shapes to fill, you will often get undesired results like I got here. This happens because the vectors in the DXF files do not connect to the last decimal place. But the SeaCAD has a solution for this with the auto connect feature, which connects the ends of nearby vectors. Now the letter S is correctly filled, but the round logo is still not okay. To solve this, you need to check these two checkmarks in the fill menu and then it should work correctly. I engraved this pattern on my pliers using a fast speed and a single pass. The engraving was not dark enough, so I lowered the speed and did two passes. Now the result is very good. This laser is good at engraving metal. It also engraves anodized aluminum beautifully. You can buy these blanks in bulk online, engrave them and sell them for a good profit. It can also engrave plastics too. Here I tried engraving black acrylic. It melts the surface and leaves a very nice white engravings, which are lifted out from the surface and are very durable. I also engraved this white plastic power bank. It leaves a nice dark finish, which is easily readable, and it is very durable and permanent. The Enjoywood M4 can be used for engraving barcodes of any kind, and it can also generate QR codes easily. Then you fill the shapes and engrave them in seconds. Feel free to scan this code if you want. You can use this laser also for marking serial numbers or custom text in a series production. SeaCAD supports automatic serial number increment, automatic date and time engraving, and you can also import predetermined text from a CSV format. You can also use the button on the side of the machine, which is meant for repeated work. If you want to protect your designs from being copied, you can also use this engraver to remove markings from integrated circuits. Now that's a feature which developers can appreciate. Please like this video if you have learned something new. And consider subscribing to stay in tune with everything laser related. Thanks for watching.